Ladies, can I please continue editing my old videos in peace? Let me start off by saying, I don't want to turn this channel into a channel of me defending black men, defending black kings, as some of y'all would say, but I had to stop what I was doing to address this. And I'm going to keep on doing so until us black women get it. Stop being on defense mode all the time. We have to stop it. I'm calling the bullshit out as I see it, whether it's going to make y'all uncomfortable or not. But let's be real, it have to be talked about. It have to be addressed, especially with y'all keep jumping to conclusions like y'all do. Black women, we just have to keep calling each other out on our bullshit. You know, more like each one teach one. If you see lint in my hair, get that shit out. You my sister, get it out. If I see you behaving in a club crazy, I'm gonna call you out on your bullshit. I'm that girl, and I hope people would do the same for me. When I'm doing wrong, call me out. When I'm jumping to conclusions, call me out. And trust me, I'ma call black men out. I did a lot of videos where I called out black men period, out when they were wrong. Us is the black community. We need to stick together. I feel like us black women, we are the worst when it comes to taking accountability and when accepting constructive criticism. I feel we have a hard time dealing with those two things. So I'm here today to talk about what went down on social media concerning Ari Lennox and Snoop. Now, Ari Lennox is a natural hair girl with beautiful natural hair, may I add. And she's also a kind of like soul singer, just a good representation for the natural hair community. She makes music for them, and she just a well-rounded, cool, down-to-earth, funny girl. In my opinion, she can be a little annoying sometimes. Maybe because I'm much older than her, she hardly ever wear wigs. And if she wearing wigs, it's more like of a joke thing. It's more like her entertaining her audience type of thing. You know, with the whole lace wigs and things like that. So again, she's known for her natural hair. When you think Ari Lennox, you think natural hair. Okay, keep that in mind. But long story short, when the whole Gayle versus Snoop came about, Ari Lennox was team Snoop and just pretty much saying how Gayle was wrong, and she was. And for me personally, it wasn't even about me taking her for black men, but overall, Gayle was wrong. And it wasn't even about her bashing black men. It wasn't even about Oprah bashing black men. And overall, that is my issue. But at that time, with Gayle and Kobe, I was more upset because the man is dead. Where I come from, we was raised not to speak on the dead, not to disrespect the dead. Let's get back to the topic. Ari Lennox took up for Snoop around that time. Okay, let's fast forward to now. She's on live, doing what she do best, entertaining her crowd. She's playing with lace wigs, and her wig that she was trying to put on top of all that natural hair, it wouldn't lay flat. Now, let's be clear. I really think it was a joke. She wasn't going to really go outside with it. I think, again, she was entertaining her fans, and it wouldn't lay flat, and she just started acting silly and crazy, just being her. Silly, cool, down-to-earth girl. Shade Room posted. And Snoop says, under that post, grow your own hair. What happened to those days? Then, boom, an explosion went off. The point Snoop was trying to get across was simply, Ari, you're known for your beautiful, natural hair. Why don't you just wear your own hair? Now, again, Snoop, I'm sure, seen her on a Shade Room, and I'm sure he probably didn't understand her personality and just was like, hey, whatever happened to wearing your own hair? And that's what I think he was trying to say, but grow your own hair came out. Okay, ladies, and just say, if he was really saying grow your own hair, whatever happened to those days, or wear your own hair, whatever happened to those days, me personally, that's what I think he was trying to say, because grow your own hair, we all know Ari Lennox is known for the hair she have on her head, which is full, thick, beautiful, natural hair. So I think he just typed it wrong, because we all know Ari Lennox have hair already. So I don't think he meant to say grow your own hair. I think what he was trying to say was wear your own hair. Black women, honestly, calm down for a second. Calm down. Now ask yourself, what was wrong with what Snoop said? Y'all know Snoop didn't say nothing wrong. And how is he going against black women by encouraging Ari Lennox to simply wear her hair? hair. Wear the hair that literally grows out of your head. How is that anti-black, ladies? How? How? Snoop is a black man telling another black woman to pretty much embrace her own hair that grows out of her head. So if Snoop would have said, I hate black hair, I hate kinky hair, he still would have been considered anti-black to y'all black women. You can't win for losing with y'all. He's telling her to wear her hair, to embrace her hair, take that wig off, and he's kind of confused, like, what is she doing with a wig? She got all that pretty hair. Take that wig off, wear your own hair. Or if he would have said, I don't like black hair, keep the wig on, then y'all would have been still upset. Like, really, black women? Like, really? Make up y'all minds. When I seen that he was trending and Ari was trending, and for what I said, we have to do better, black women, honestly. I just did a video about how y'all was bashing Steven Johnson. Check that video out, and I'll leave that in the description. It really have to stop. So, Ari Lennox, if you come across this video, I am going to tag her in it. Please don't believe the hype. Snoop did not mean anything wrong. Don't let these women gas you up, especially these black women that had a lot of hate for themselves and just was done so wrong by black men, just harboring around all this hate. And of course, I was going back and forth with somebody on Twitter that eventually blocked me. They couldn't argue my point because I was right. Snoop did not mean no type of malice. And we all know Snoop not no damn angel. We all know how he treats his wife. And let me say this, if he was wrong and coming at the Ari Lennox hair, trust me, I would have been on him. I would have been the first one to call him out on his bullshit. Like I did with P. Diddy, always talking about black excellence, black this, black love. But the only black woman he had, he treated like garbage. And don't get me wrong, I'm big on preference. That's not colorism. A lot of us get colorism and preference mixed up. P. Diddy have a preference. He loved his light-skinned women. But stop trying to impress the black community on your social media by hashtagging black love, black excellence, black is beautiful, and all that bullshit. So that's what I called him out on. And I'll leave that in the description. So I do call the men out on their bullshit. I'm just trying to get black women to see a new day. And I don't know why this girl keep popping up on my timeline. And I even asked my daughter, because she's younger, millennial, more tech savvy. I said, why is this person keep popping up on my timeline? And my daughter said, 9 times out of 10, you and her have the same audience. And she's a large YouTuber, Paris Million. She got these black women so brainwashed, it's sad. And I mean, like I said, I don't watch her. I never can watch a full video of hers. She's just so annoying. And I'm not trying to be smart, but y'all keep on fucking around with that Paris Million. Because if y'all don't know, Paris Million hates black men. Upon doing research on her, she only dates white men, black women. And y'all follow this girl. She's clearly angry. Really, black women, we have to do better. Y'all gotta get it together. Because while she on the white man train, she's willing y'all asses into self-hate. It's okay to listen to somebody else's views, but don't let her views shape you. Y'all fuck around while she with her white man, y'all gonna be sitting up here 10, 20, 30 years single and wondering the fuck why. Because over the years, by listening to this girl, y'all absorbed all this hate and animosity towards black men. And don't think I'm this girl, save all black men. Black men is the shit. Black men is my kings. Fuck no. God is my king. All that, my man is my king. Oh, fuck no. I don't get down like that. That's just not me. But I do, again, the fact that I have brothers and nephews and been raised around nothing but men and raised boys to men, which is my nephews. I seen what they go through. I see what they go through. Being black, living in America. So again, I have this soft spot and always will. It's the saying my mother used to always say, you hang around a barbershop too long, you're bound to get a haircut. Y'all keep listening to her, y'all gonna be sick to y'all stomach even when y'all look at a black man. Y'all better get it together, black women. And I'm not saying not listen to her. I'm just saying, you can listen to somebody's opinion. Be your own person. Don't get absorbed into her bullshit, into her insecurities and her hurt from black men. That's so much so now she just date white men. And let's talk about Snoop's daughter. A lot of people saying, oh, she was talking about how she hated her skin and how she was dealing with colorism and how she didn't like her skin, and Snoop didn't come out and say a public statement for her. Who the fuck do we think we are where these celebrities gotta put us in their personal life? Like, really, people, when y'all having trials and tribulations at home, do y'all go on y'all social media and say, oh, I was $20 late today for rent, I was $20 short today for rent, 1 month behind on my mortgage? That is personal. We don't know what tactics they use to boost her self-esteem. Who do we think we are? Look at Beyonce and Jay-Z with Blue Ivy. Blue Ivy goes to confidence class because black women like us, black women, the same black women that has Blue Ivy features that Blue Ivy has, we have. And y'all bash that girl, something terrible, where Beyonce gotta put that little young girl in confidence class because of black girls and black women like us that look just like her calling her ugly. Think about that. Beyonce got that girl in confidence class because of the black fucking women. Not the black men, but the black women. Paris Million, did you talk about that? No, you didn't. But let a black man say something that you think is offensive, you ready to do a video on him. Girl, sit your ass down and stop trying to gas these women up and trying to be, oh, I'm team black girls. You ain't thinking about these black women. Why you with your white man? Girl, cut it out. And I want to address this also. A lot of people came posting pictures of Snoop's wife and his daughter with all this fake hair in their head. So fucking what? Snoop was telling Ari Lennox, a person, now remember I said I was going to keep coming back to this, a person that's known for natural hair, for their beautiful natural hair, to wear their own hair. So what does Snoop's daughter and Snoop's wife have to do with Ari Lennox or Snoop's statement? They not known for natural hair, but I see how the black women tried to flip the script and flip the narrative and say, oh, well, Snoop, you got a nerve to talk. Y'all really have to get it together, black women. I'm telling y'all, and I'm going to keep calling y'all out on y'all bullshit until y'all get it. Y'all have to understand social media is not real life. So, ladies, the whole point Snoop was trying to make, being though Ari Lennox is known for her natural hair, he was just encouraging her to wear her hair. Ari Lennox voluntarily told us that her wig wouldn't lay down. Playing. Snoop replied, a simple solution, guys. That's all. A simple solution. Wear your hair. Grow your hair. No malice intended. Just wear your hair. Anyone who was offended by that are just insecure, and I think have been hurt really bad by these men. And you gotta let that hurt go. Having all that hate and anger harbored in you, I'm telling you, ladies, y'all will be looking crazy. Y'all gonna be looking 60 at 30. Y'all cannot hate all men because of one black man that hurted y'all in y'all life. And y'all keep saying black men don't support us. Well, y'all don't support them. And why do y'all need black celebrity support? Black stranger support? Don't y'all have men in y'all family that love y'all? Why do y'all need validation from celebrities? The real question is, do you love yourself? Ask yourself that. When his daughter spoke publicly about colorism, it wasn't to say she had low self-esteem. She spoke about colorism to uplift other young girls who may have had self-hate because of their skin. So again, we don't know what interventions her parents took to boost that girl's self-esteem. You know, we have to do better, black women. We got to. Ladies, until you love yourself, you're going to be looking for love in all the wrong places. Have y'all ever heard of the saying, no one is going to love you until you love yourself? That's a true saying, and it goes without saying. And I always preach something that I stand by, and I say it in a lot of my videos when I call the black community out on their bullshit, such as this: until we take ourselves serious, no one else will. Until next time, YouTube, peace.